The difference between fresh and frozen embryo transfer is just what it says. A fresh transfer means the egg is fertilized and it's never frozen. It's cultured for anywhere from 3 to 5 days and then it's transferred back as a fresh embryo. If you don't do that, then the embryos, of course, have to be frozen to be able to be utilized at a later date. And one of the main reasons couples choose to freeze embryos is to allow for chromosomal screening, to do chromosomal testing of embryos, which takes a week or 10 days to get results on. We have to freeze them to allow for time for the testing. And of course, transferring an embryo that you know is chromosomally normal has a big advantage, but again, it requires a frozen embryo transfer. As it turns out, the uterus is probably more receptive in a frozen transfer, because on a fresh transfer, you've just been hyperstimulated with lots of fertility drugs for 10 days or more, and your hormone levels, particularly estrogen and progesterone, are very out of whack compared to a natural cycle. So studies have shown that when you freeze the embryos and you let the uterus return to normal hormone levels, that implantation or pregnancy rates with that embryo can actually go up. So there's certainly advantages to a frozen transfer in terms of a more receptive uterus, and again, advantages in that you can allow for chromosomal screening. So for these reasons, the majority of our patients, probably 90%, do frozen embryo transfers to take advantage of these concepts. Thanks. Yeah.